We're back.
And we are back.
I'm not sure that was definitely under 2 minutes, but I think, you know, wasn't bad.
Thanks for bearing with us, guys. Like we said, we're going to go straight through into new products from Qualatex. And then from there, we're going to talk a little bit about Ozjam. We're going to do hands-on twisting live in the studio to make a princess.
What could go wrong?
Everything. Then we've got talking about some competitions that are currently running with Qualatex. And we've got a top tip about weights.
Yay!
We've done that. We're back. No pictures, Uber. Hey, Hetty. Oh, there we go. Eve, can we have... Are we good? Is everybody good? Can everybody see us?
Someone says we've got no picture.
Zubair, have you got your eyes closed again? We're definitely on, aren't we?
Well, we can see us.
Yeah, we can see us.
We can see us and we can see us and we can
see
us.
Yeah, let's do this, Dom.
All good, thanks. Thank you, Alfred.
Yeah,
thanks,
awesome.
Evie. Much appreciated.
Zubair. Just refresh your YouTube, I'm sure.
Yeah,
something to do with
Zuba,
that.
You may be on the... must be on the new one because he's talking to us.
I don't know. Maybe he talks to himself.
Maybe he does.
Right, okay, let's get
Thanks,
straight into
Lindsay.
This.
Yes.
We want to talk about some new products that have just been released by Qualatex.
Oh, yes.
Always an exciting time for us. We get inspired by new products. And they're bang on trend, as always. So, shall we go over to the new product screen, Dom?
Yeah, let's do that, because I was lucky to be at Pioneer Europe HQ the other day as well.
Were you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I got...
Well, we're doing that one first, aren't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then that one. I think that one, then that one.
No,
I think definitely.
No, don't show them anything.
Oh, no, we've got to.
Why?
It's important.
Why?
Just a picture of you two with Mr. Q. No!
Who wouldn't want a picture of us two with Mr. Q?
Exactly!
Who wouldn't want that?
Refresh, buddy. Refresh.
Come on, you can do this.
You can do it.
We'll give you a second because you don't want to miss this new products.
You don't. I know that a lot of people have seen them already, but not quite like this.
And a lot of people probably haven't seen it, which we'll come on to that very shortly.
Yeah, we'll show you exactly how to find out first where these new products are showcased.
Yes, okay. So should we share something? Or...
Yeah, I think we should do it.
Okay.
Do it. Here we go, ready?
Let's do it.
Hi, everyone. And we want to show you some new products that are coming in this next quarter from Qualatex.
An exciting quarter it is.
It is very exciting.
I'm going to show you what's hot, though. These brand new birthday balloons from Qualatex. These are hot. Whoa. These are nice. These are really nice.
Really nice birthday balloons, Dom.
I'm looking forward to selling some of these ones.
But are they hot enough?
Yeah.
No. I think what's really hot is this.
Wow.
This is hot.
You're telling me it's hot.
We're right here in the desert because, as everybody knows, bang on trend at the moment are all
somewhere.
The
somewhere.
Cacti.
Cactus.
No, not cactuses. Cacti.
Cactuses.
We've got all these fantastic cacti designs.
Okay, I'll concede.
That we can use in your balloon displays.
Some may say that was a prickly issue.
Oh.
Sorry.
It's getting a bit too hot here, Dom.
Let's get out of here. Let's go somewhere a bit cooler.
Okay, well, how about going up?
Okay.
Whoa!
I'm not sure if I like it up here.
Oh, this is really cool. Look, I can see the pub from here.
We should have got that the vintage red plane. Oh. That's what we should have got. That would have been better for this travelling.
It's very true. That 3D one by Shippy, really nice.
Really cool.
But we're here because we want to show you about a new range that's coming.
Is it hot?
I think so.
I think it's on trend.
Here we go. Have a look at all these designs. Everybody loves a rainbow.
Certainly do. I'm looking for that pot of gold.
So that's new products from quarter two from Qualatex.
Yes.
Enjoy them, use them, share them with us so we can see what you guys are doing.
Looking forward to seeing those pictures.
Welcome back!
Well, that was a nice new product.
Yeah, we get to go everywhere.
Sky's the limit.
Absolutely. We get to go to parties, and then we get to go to the desert, and then we get to go to the cloudlands.
Because that's where everyone wants to be.
But seriously, though, the guys, I don't know if you've been taking notice of social media and just in the stores and everything. Cacti are really hot at the moment. They're so everywhere.
They are. Everything, it's, you know, from toiletry, lots of different products.
Home decor and from kids' toys.
Strong influences. So for themed birthday parties or just adding a bit of fun into an everyday event, it's just a nice way and some brilliant coordinating products there.
And also, coming up... Oh, we're not allowed to say, are we?
Oh, I think you can.
Oh,
No.
Just stay tuned. There may be more stuff coming. Okay? So stay tuned. Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
But what else? We need to show them where they can find this stuff out.
Yes, because a lot of people miss the fact that there's new products out there. So there is, as Keith says, the links on social media, and they do point people in the right directions. But a lot of that's fed from the main Qualatex website. So on the main Qualatex website, we have got...
there we go. That's qualatex.com.
This is the main page. First page when you go onto qualatex.com. We'll redirect depending on where you are, but...
Just near the bottom there, you can see where it says Our Products. Now, you can see what's hot, what's new, and it's got the autumn and winter, but just next to it is what's new Q2 2018, which is quarter two 2018
releases. Episode 5, Missy, Keith with the glasses.
Maybe on that size screen.
Maybe. But if you select that particular second image there on that main page, it will take you through into the filtered product selection. So this is the screen where it shows all the products available from Qualatex. In there now, it's filtered down at the top. It shows you it's got 13 new products for quarter two. So it's showing latex, foils, bubbles, whatever's there, it's going to show you. And then obviously with each one of those, you can select it and click into it and have a look at the further information and see if there's anything there, like related information.
I like that wild birthday one, that have a wild birthday one. I particularly like that toucan. It's really cool bird.
It is.
Yeah. Also the take on the happy birthday with the rainbow as well. We're using the pastel shades, which are bang on trend at the moment.
Yeah, very much so.
Because, you know, we've got the heart shape as well. Which yes. is the striking colours of the normal rainbow. But we've got a pastel assortment, which is really... I think that's going to be really nice.
Yeah, well, we've done a lot of rainbow and pastel assortment styles for first birthdays, baby showers, and obviously the older birthdays as well. But it's just one that lends itself very much to those age groups. So that's just a really nice...
And all the cactus there, you can see the happy birthday cactus. And
yay.
The little cactus there with the face on it.
Cute well. Characters. Cute. Which is always nice.
New diamond shape too. Always love the diamond shapes.
All about the diamonds.
There's the happy birthday there. You can see it in pink. And there's also the blue version. And there's the latex to go along with it.
Yeah. I love coordinating products. That's yeah. what makes our day very much easier.
Available in the diamond clear, which makes it easier
yay.
To use on any colour.
Which is what we like about Qualatex. It's all yay. Easy.
So yay. that's part of the Q2, but there was one
easy,
on there.
Easy for you to see.
I know, there was one on there on that last screen that we didn't show.
That one there, yeah.
That top left, the yeah. Star Wars one with Leia, Rey, was it Jin and Rose?
Yeah,
well, see, I remember that very easily.
Yeah, it's because it's written there. Keith.
Yes,
yes. But we were looking at this earlier and saying that the fact that it's in a very different colour palette from your traditional Star Wars.
Absolutely, and the Star Wars range available from Qualatex is expanding and expanding because the license is so huge. It's a massive opportunity for us for decor and the retail side.
Yeah,
so
exceptionally strong license that one.
It is, but what have we got available?
Oh, I don't know.
Do you know? Do we know?
I don't know.
Shall
but I
we?
Think we know.
I think we should take a look.
Let's have a look.
Let's have a look. Welcome to the Qualatex Mothership.
Yeah. It's cool up here, isn't it?
It is. In space, nobody can hear you eat ice cream.
Sorry?
Apparently. I said, doesn't matter, Dom. So welcome to the Q spaceship. We're here to introduce you to some new products.
Out of this world products.
Oh, you'd be over the moon with these products.
Anyway, we have new latex. We also have some we've got the new bubble. We have some of the older ones that we want to reintroduce you in case you missed them before. Can't think why, but you never know.
We have a lot of Star Wars fans out there.
Yes, yeah, Star Wars fans. May the 4th be with you. Like, almost May the 4th.
Almost. I particularly like the new latex though because the colours are definitely more catered to our female audience, and we definitely have a lot of Star Wars fans in the female.
Yes, they're not so masculine as the older ones were. So, we have, let's have a look, just lean back a bit.
Nice.
We have our new latex inside of this double bubble.
That's pretty cool.
It is, with the details here. We need to get inside. We want to go inside the bubble. Have a closer look.
Ah, yes.
Ready? Shrink ray. Here we are, inside the bubble.
This is pretty cool.
I've never been inside of a bubble before.
This is my first time.
Technically, it's helium filled as well, so we shouldn't be doing this.
We're trained professionals.
Yes. Okay, so looking closely at what we've got here, we're loving the new design.
Very much so.
With Ray and Rose and the rest of the team.
Jane and, well, you know, please don't bring on the Star Wars haters.
Yeah. So this is what it looks like up close and personal. I think it's time to leave the bubble.
Time to go. Let's not forget the range that we're currently used to using. I particularly like the 5-inch range that we have.
Yeah, what such as we got the Droid Collection. We also have Darth Vader.
Nice.
And Dom's personal favourite, Chewbacca. What do you think, Dom? Also in the range is we have all the different various bubbles that you can see around us. We've got the Death Star double bubble.
My personal favourite.
Yeah, I like that one too. We like the old school ones. We've got the old school, we've got the Rebel Alliance, and we've got the Last Jedi and the Force Awakens.
And not forgetting the long lasting bubbles are great for retail and decor. Perfect for parties and walk out the door sales.
We also have all the coordinating latex. And quick links.
Just be sure to check your local distributor for availability of licenses in your area.
Couldn't have said it better than myself. So, it's bye from the Q Mothership.
Bye for now.
May the 4th be with you.
Check that out!
Well, I can say sorry.
And who said that we didn't have a huge budget, guys?
Because
we've got our own spaceship. How cool's that? I don't think any other balloon show has a spaceship, Dom.
Nor should they. So, we've been to outer space, we've been in the clouds. Where to next, Keith? Oh, I know.
Yeah. One second, we talk about the... Let's talk about the... I'm lost off now.
Products.
Let's talk about the...
Don't dwell on them.
Star Wars.
Move on.
Yeah, just bear that in mind that it wasn't Star Trek because somebody mentioned before that I was wearing a red shirt and the red shirts always get killed first in Star Trek.
That's somebody being his wife.
Yeah. So it's...
And she was particularly on being dead today.
So it's Star Wars on that one, guys.
Yes, just be aware.
Did we enjoy that? Was it a bit of fun? But also you found out about the range available of the Star Wars products.
But again, going back to the products on the Qualatex website, don't forget to check out each one of those Qualatex pictures for the Star Wars range, because you can download the images separately, which you can use
as long as you're a QBN member.
True. But you can also then look at the related images, related inspiration.
The related inspiration. It's really cool.
For bouquets that are finished, different designs. Again, QBM members, you get access to those. And then you've got so much content that you can use for within your business, for a portfolio, advertising to your customers. It takes out so much effort and work and very, very well edited either photographs or CGI versions of them, but they are, you know, the professional level, and they're fantastic, and they're what we use in our business. So
exactly, it's well worth it, and it's a free resource as long as you're a Qualatex Balloon Network member.
Yay, go
so
us.
If you're not, sign up. It's always a good thing.
And again, on the Qualatex website, check
Qualatex.com.
out the Qualatex QBN Network section. Loads of information there. And also additionally on Sue Baller's very best balloon blog, there's heaps of information about the QBN and the CBA, so the Qualatex Balloon Network, and the Certified Balloon Artists. Have a read through that. If anyone's ever stuck, just shout out, because it's such a phenomenal
resource,
yeah, and also a thing to be involved in, and it's beneficial to your business.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay.
So where to next?
Where to next?
Oh, let me find out. Whoa.
Why? Look at that.
Oh, hang on. Something's gone wrong.
We're in training. Can you tell where we're going next?
Oh, that's right. We did say, yes. Yes, Evie, you're right.
Many, many advantages of the QBN.
Many.
But this is in training. Because yes. In August...
We're getting ready for this. We've got a long trip ahead.
We're going down under.
We are.
I reckon.
We're down under. Many days of travelling to get there. I hope it's going to be worth it.
So if I know it's like 3 in the morning or something like that, or 3:30 in the morning down in Australia at the moment. So if anybody's up...
Australia.
This is not the accent challenge, Dom. If anybody's up, what are you doing up? Although we really appreciate it.
Yes.
Because we love you guys.
All one of yous. So, yes, we're getting used to it. Let's try and get this.
Let's flip.
There we go.
There we go.
I'm back. I feel better now. Okay. Yes.
So, there are many different events, Qualatex-sponsored events or Qualatex-run events around the world.
There is. But there are some that are, you know, better than others.
Yes.
The ones that we get to go to. I class that because I get to go to them rather than the fact that other people get to go to them and we're there.
We just had the Olympics of, or what's classed as the Olympics of the Balloon World, which is the World Balloon Convention.
We were working out for that one for quite a bit.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Yes.
Although we've got a lot of travelling this year anyway, we've got a big one happening in August, which we've been signed up for a couple of years.
We'll say hi to our families right now, because this is probably the best chance we've got.
Yeah,
hi, family. Miss you.
Yeah, because we know we might not come back.
Yeah, we're away a little bit.
Okay.
We love you. But August, Australia, very much looking forward to this one, because one of the first things that we said to ourselves when we started teaching was Australia was one of the ones we wanted to get to, and by hook or by crook we've managed to
we've been invited down under
for
a barbie.
Doesn't mean we'll be invited back, but it does mean we've been invited for the first time,
and so we're really looking forward to it for the team down there. Bruce, Rochelle, and now David on board as well.
Yay.
Matt, Dave,
yay,
big shout out, guys, thank you very much.
So we've got,
we'll be first of all with the if you're thinking about going to AusJam, the early bird deadline is fastly approaching. There we go. It's the 30th of April, so you have 4 days if you're already based in Australia, or 5 days if you're here.
Yeah, we got more time.
Yeah, because like the Australians are in the future.
But there is a...
it's like space. They're in the future.
A substantial discount off the delegate price. And I think there's a group delegate price as well, I believe.
Check it out. Have a look on AusJam.
Yeah.
But
lots of information there, so that's pretty cool. Have a read up on that. But again, any questions, just give us a shout. We can point you in the right direction.
There was a cool, cool promo video.
Oh, there was, yeah.
That was done. So we'd like to share it. Not enough people got to see this, so it's a bit of fun. Enjoy, guys.
we're back.
We are. We're here. Yes.
Super excited.
Yay. Very much so.
We hope to see as many of you guys down there as well. Also, we will be doing a very special Q Corner episode.
We certainly will be.
While we're in Oz.
We also get to meet up with lots of other instructors because this is kind of a reunion one. So they've had Oz Jams previously and they've had other instructors teach at all the previous ones. And they're I think, all coming back pretty much. So we've got a good lineup for this one. So we've got...
So we have, look, we've got...
Oh yeah.
On there.
You look, I'll read. So we've got David and Shayna, we've got me, we've got Matt Fallon, Phileas Flash, Tina G, Nicole Gregg, Amanda Griffiths, Jeff Hayes, Pip. Milford Hughes, we've got Ray Stewart.
Me! We've got me!
Ken Stillman, Keith Sturman.
It's me.
David Taylor and the wonderful Cam. Oh,
and there's somebody that's hidden as well behind a logo.
What's going on up there? Oh,
there we go.
He was too tall. You can fit on the picture. It's the Adamo.
So that's quite a line up there.
Sorry, Chris.
And yes.
Brandon's important.
Yes, Mike. Dom's luggage might turn up in New Orleans or something instead.
Yeah.
We can only hope.
It's probably true.
Oh, we're still on there. That's switch the thingy off. There we go.
We'll get rid of that.
That one.
There we go.
That's quite a lineup, guys.
It is.
So if you have the opportunity, please jump on it. If you're thinking about it, do it quick because that early bird deadline is fast approaching.
It certainly is. So yes, we're looking forward to that one. What have we got next? Oh, I know what we've got next.
We've got our calendar winner for this month.
Yes.
So we've got our picture up there, the calendar, which is Andre Van Zenten, if I pronounce that name right. I apologise, Andre.
Andre.
Okay. A really nice guy. Managed to speak to him for a little bit. And he's a twister mainly, but does decor as well. And he sent us a tutorial.
Nice photo of that one as well, though.
So instead of the normal... in the normal tutorial where we play the tutorial at speed or whatever, because this is a more of a twisting, we thought we would do it live.
We thought we'd join in.
Don't know if that's a great idea because
I haven't
live.
Seen the video yet.
I had a quick look.
I'll let you decide if it's a good idea.
I inflated the balloons to the sizes that I think they are, so you're not sitting here waiting for us inflating. And it's quick enough for us to do live, which is what I think's really cool about it.
We'll see.
We'll find out. Also, as well, for those that like hairbanders, it's going to be... We could put this on a hairband, but there's no reason why you can't get it to sit into a base or any part of the design.
Yeah.
Which is why we think it's really nice. These hairbands were got from a local cheap store in the UK, Home Bargains, £6 or something, and the fabric covered. We know that you can get them cheaper and things, but we don't go through a massive amount of hairbands.
If you're doing bulk and doing lots of them for, you know, as a twister at parties, there's quite a few places that you can buy them in a really good volume at a really good price. But for us who doesn't do it very often, specifically the hairbands, just being able to buy them in smaller quantities is ideal. And the price difference is negligible.
Also,
for
fabric covered as well, which makes them just a little bit more higher end for us, I think. Yeah. So we're going to use these two. Although that looks green now then there. I thought it was yellow before. But
it is green.
It is green.
Yeah.
Yeah. I might use this one instead then.
The white.
I'm going to use the white.
Cool.
Because we're going to follow along, but we've changed the colours a little bit.
Because he can.
So...
Let's move us down here, okay?
We need to go onto a smaller camera.
We're back.
Oh, there we go.
So we're going down here. We're going to bring our friend Andre in. So are we ready?
We've got no way of pausing this, have we?
No, we literally are doing this.
Oh, hold on a minute. Oh, the watch is going to have to get on, come off here.
It's like the Q Corner Challenge.
I haven't stretched. 1 second. Oh.
It's Q Corner Challenge all over here.
Oh. Yeah.
I don't see this going that well. I've got a bag of balloons and I'm thinking... What's this going to be?
It's going to be some balloons, don't
I? Heard princess and that's
it. Is. It's a really cute princess.
Okay. So we'll run the video, but at any point if it restarts, it wasn't because I restarted it because I needed to. It was because something happened accidentally.
I know that I need to start with this balloon.
I need to start with?
This balloon.
This balloon.
No, you start with the pale blue. I'm doing goldenrod.
Okay.
And Dom's going to do pale blue.
Much as
And Andre is going to do it in spring lilac, I seem to remember.
Okay, so let's put Andre on then and then see.
Wish us luck, guys.
Yeah.
No safety net. This is live.
So let's see. That.
Let's listen to him because he's a nice guy.
Hello, guys. Thank you for having me on the show. Today, I'm going to show you how to make this lovely princess on a hairband.
Beautiful.
I hope
princess.
You enjoy it.
Cheers.
We will enjoy it, buddy. There we go. A couple of 260s, a 160, a hairband, and a quick link 6-inch blush.
First, we start with a 5-petal flower.
Okay, we're making small flowers. Okay. Try and keep up with them. He's done 3. He's done 4. He's done 5. Straighten that up. Right, he's making a small bubble. And then a double pin twist. I think I've overinflated this balloon.
Yeah, no way, really.
So it's a double pin twist.
No, it's a triple.
No, it's a double pin twist. Double pin twist. And that's going back down there. So I'm going to have to let a little bit of air out there.
I was hoping for the best.
And twist that in. Round there.
160.
Okay.
What do you do with that button?
Get rid of it.
Okay.
And then, what's he got there?
What we've got?
We need one of them, Dom. We're going to make small loops.
That's the time into the 5-petal flower.
So one and 2 loops. He's already catching up.
Speed frantic.
Speed twisting, Andre. Speed twisting. That's going round there.
Okay. You know when you wish you'd made it beforehand? It might have been a good idea.
I know, but where's the fun in that? Live life on the edge. I'm sure to everybody else, all they can hear is a lot of squeaks.
Aye.
So that's going up around there. Right, around the double pin twist. Okay, I see where that is. Okay. Twist that in.
Rest.
In there. And get rid of that.
Okay, right. Hi. Don't worry.
Okay, look. So we have the little princess.
Okay, I see.
So now we have 6-inch quickling. And I need a mocha. You need yellow.
Loop twist.
All right. Okay.
So what we're doing is, first of all, we're creating a loop.
Pinch twist.
Followed by a pinch twist.
Okay. I see.
Are you with us so far?
Who's following along at home? Anybody? Did anyone get the balloons out?
Okay. And then we twist that around the knot.
Back up to the pinch.
And then we come back up and we twist that around the pinch twist.
And up to the
pinch. He lost yours down
there. I lost it down there. And that's round there.
Is that 3 or 4 now, son?
4. Four. I need to go back up a 4th time.
And then please make a bubble at the end. Just
4th time up. At least go this side. Okay, and he's created a loop on there. So we'll do a little bubble on there. And we'll twist that around the pinch twist.
Mine's sort of the same.
Yeah, I don't think I've created a big enough loop on the back of here, but we got the idea.
The hair. Oh. My hair is slightly different, but you know, hairstyles are all, you know.
So now we can wrap this around the double pinch twist. Tie it in.
I don't like it though.
I think it's cute as anything.
And the princess is ready.
And then we have. Oh, she's looking back.
Okay, right, I see. Sideways.
Oh, and then we need to tie this in. I'm doing this into here.
Okay.
Of course, you can make different variations on this design. Like a famous mouse on a hairband.
A mouse.
That is very cool.
And look at that, that's Aurora.
I hope you enjoy my tutorial.
I've done. What have I done? I've done belt.
One second.
Back screen.
There we go. Yay!
So I've got Belle.
Ding 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 ding. I've got another
Cinderella.
Carrie.
Sorry. Obviously not. Yeah. Sorry.
Well, I wasn't thinking that. I was thinking I don't know who these characters are because I got boys at home and they,
yeah.
these characters don't exist.
These are really cute.
They are.
And super sellable.
Funny thing
as well.
Is, it does obscure our brand new, if anyone's noticed, our 100 years.
100-year sign, 100 years of Pioneer Balloon Company.
It's our very brand new poster, which has been made out of our... I've got to take this off. Made out of
Evie,
our,
you said totally cute. Is that us or the balloons?
We know this. We know we're totally cute.
Oh, thank you.
But this is our... We thought we had one of the balloons left for the 100 years, so we framed it.
Yes.
So the next time it comes round, we've got one.
Ready for the next 100 years.
Yeah.
Just in case.
Just in case. You never know.
Be prepared.
No, I like them. I think that is something we could even start offering out in the shop.
I think it's super sellable.
Yeah.
You know, I think this one. On a base with a bubble or something like that from the licensed stuff.
Yeah, but also even as add-ons for parties where we have a selection of princesses that they can take to add out as party favours type.
Like if we do an arch or something like that, you can add them into the arch so that people can take them away as extra interactive giveaways.
Interactive decor. We like that.
We like stuff like
that. Thank you, Princess.
And thank you very much, Andrea.
Yeah, that was a fantastic tutorial. Really appreciate that.
We're going to post this separate. We've been recording this part of the show. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this one back and we're going to cut this bit out and we'll post it again by itself for everybody to follow along. And like Hetty said as well, we would really like you guys to post pictures.
Yes,
and I'm sure Andrea
please.
Would love it as well if you saw that. So
onto
take the
Mr.
idea.
Q Facebook page.
Yes.
Or you can post it in hashtag in Q Corner Show.
Yeah, hashtag Q Corner will do. Yeah, hashtag Q Corner
hashtag
on Instagram.
Easy for you to say.
And we'll try and grab that up. So or Q Corner or Qualatex Corner, either of the two would be awesome.
Yes, it would.
I might leave this one. I quite like it.
Yours is all right. Mine was getting in the way of stuff and I didn't like the new sign being covered up. Was it?
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Yeah. But that was very good, though.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, because he did that for us especially as well.
And
so.
Fast as well. Yeah, absolutely, Evie.
Yeah.
They are very fast to do. I mean, that was... we just blasted them out there live in front of you guys. Didn't go horribly wrong.
No, could have done. Easily.
Yes. That's another thing we would like you to do. If you want to challenge us to make something... Yeah, we're not going to take all challenges, but if you'd like to challenge us to make something, you can always send us a tutorial video and we'd like to do it live. If
Keith would very much like to do that live.
If we like the design and things and we can do it in Q Corner live, we would love to do that. So please send us some challenges. Doesn't matter how tricky they are, we'll try and have a go.
They don't call it 19 takes, Sturman, for nothing.
Absolutely. This is one and done, man. That's why we do things live.
Yeah. Superb. Oh, now...
Hope you enjoyed that. Thanks, guys. Leave comments.
And also say thank you to Andre as well, because he did that, especially for you guys, the QCon audience. So
and we didn't even need any spare balloons.
You know why? You know why?
Qualatex balloons done.
Exactly.
There's your guarantee of satisfaction. All right.
You should patent that.
Yep.
Okay, so we have got now...
We've got, after the princess, we've got... Ah, we've got a special guest star.
Yeah, but this kind of links into our set just there, where we talked about the calendar.
How did Andre end up in the calendar?
Yeah.
He wasn't approached.
No, it's up to you. You need to reach out to Qualatex and send them your pictures. Now, there's a few things going on at the moment. There's a few different deadlines because we've got different competitions which have different specifications.
Image front cover. We've got the new color quest.
Yeah,
and we've got the calendar as well for next year.
So three different things going on at the moment.
Too much information for us to give out. So we had to bring in a professional.
Yep, because that's not here.
What are you trying to say? We're professional in our own and unique way.
Yeah, so we're going to go from this camera
to the other cam. Can we go to Cam Cam?
Let's go to the Cam Cam.
Hey, Q Corner people. My name is Cam Woody. I'm the executive art director here at Pioneer Balloon Company. I want to tell you about a few contests that we have going right now. The first one I want to talk about is the Balloon Images cover contest. I wanted to show you. I don't know how many people have told me they want to be on the cover of Balloon Images magazine. Well, here's your chance. Just send in your photos to us. We have a deadline for this particular contest of May 18th. But we will go through all the photos that are submitted and pick out the best photo for our cover. Some things we look for on the cover are balloons that tell a story and showcase our product in the best light. We like covers that have an atmosphere and feeling to them that make you want to buy balloons, of course. This one was by Tanya Jo Solowski in South Africa, and she's created this beautiful rainbow color theme for one of her parties. It's made a fabulous cover. And you can see it's not just balloon decor, it can also be bouquets. This one was the perfect example of a party scene set at a table. We even have one here by Keith and Dom. This was done in 2009. This is when they were first getting started in the balloon industry, and they sent in their cover contest and they won. It's beautiful with the tapers. Here we go, some more. But you can see there's a wide variety of covers that have been chosen in the past. So what we look for is a cover that's in a vertical format. It's important that whatever you do for the cover is in good photo quality. You can design the best decor ever, and if the photo is not good, we can't put it on the cover. So if you're really wanting to have a cover in your portfolio, I suggest that you hire a photographer, set a scene, make this what you dream your cover would be, and what you want to be proud of having your name on. There will be more information on this from Keith and Dom coming up. And there's also information in the latest issue of Images magazine. You can check on the inside back cover, and that has all the information you need for the cover contest. It's important that all the balloons in your photo feature only Qualatex products. That's very important. It's a publication of Pioneer Balloon, which features Qualatex balloons, so of course that's what we want in our photos. And then it's also important that they follow the California law, so make sure that you understand those aspects and carry them out in your submissions.
Great job, Cam.
Great job.
So as you can see there, we've got a deadline of May the 18th.
Yes.
For the cover contest. We won it back in 2009.
I do feel it was because we bombarded them with many, many, many photographs.
We did, we did. But also, we did take a lot of photographs for that particular job.
Yeah.
Which helps your chances. We took like lots of different angles and things, and then it made the job a lot easier for the judges. And the judges are not just Pioneer team, but also photographer team.
Yeah,
which we found out later on.
Which is pretty cool. I'm going to put some images up, which are some of the ones that, the previous ones and current ones. And this one was by Tanya. Tanya does a particularly good job of getting some really good photographs.
Yeah,
the decor's excellent.
She always has a photographer, which is the big thing. So it certainly helps with that situation.
Capturing that really good angle. Derek's, no, it wasn't Derek, I was saying Mings. Alex Hernandez, that's
Hernandez,
right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Great work, Alex. As always,
really nice palette of the colours in there, but just really,
the
really
clarity,
good detail piece.
It's got plenty of space to appreciate every element in that design.
Yeah, and sometimes, you know, like this photograph here, it's again Tanya. It's a really good photograph. It's a close up. It's not just one big photograph of the full room. It's a focused in, closed up shot.
But even the reflection there in the serving dishes, this one was beautiful.
It is, yes. Again, that palette of colour. Now, this one, I think, is actually the calendar.
I think the Aussies are running away with this organic thing. You guys are pretty awesome at the whole situation. You've got Tina, you've got Chris, you've got it in depth as well. You've got Alice, another Aussie.
Yay! Well, some fantastic inspirational pieces, which just kind of leads you into the rest of the actual publication, because there's so much content in there. There's a selection of people who spend a lot of time putting all that content in from around the world.
I mean, look at that photo there.
Yes, yeah.
Just
that this particular this image doesn't do it justice. It's
no.
It's dark black with a strong contrast on it. It's phenomenal.
And then we had ours in 2009, like we said,
which we don't have because you probably put it away safe somewhere.
Yeah.
But I mean, this is the current one as well. We're going, instead of calling it images, we're going to call it Tanya's.
Yeah, she seems to win the front cover. We need a lot more challenges in there, so people, please.
But these are really good.
Send them in there.
These are really good for your business, though. These are something that, you know, it's a claim to fame to be an industry publication to have front cover. you know, it's only comes out four times a year.
Yeah.
It's a quarterly publication, so to get front cover is a big ask. I mean, some of the content is phenomenal. I mean, some of the information in here and the imagery is just spectacular.
Is that the Q Corner advert in there, Dom, on the inside cover of the latest edition of Balloon Images?
I hadn't noticed that. Oh, it is correct. It is.
Oh, yeah. You're just going to flick through now to anything in particular that might be in the Balloon Images
magazine? There's some nice chrome in there, and there's some
great
information
articles
on Stuart in there, yeah, Beyond Balloons. And we what's this?
That's another article from us about five questions about finding the right price.
Really good read.
So if you do have a question about pricing as well, it's probably covered in there. Hi, San Francisco, by the way. Yeah. We see you guys.
Don't forget about hitting your marketing target as well.
There we go.
Another two-page read with, I would say, three handsome chaps.
Yeah. Well done, Stuart.
So, yes. It's also got in it as well, which is really good.
Oh, this edition, yeah.
This has got all the lineup from the WBC competition.
No, that's the... Well, that was the 2017 Q Tour.
The World Tour. Sorry, yeah, my mistake.
From the World Tour. And it's got all of the competition entries in there. There's we've got some Halloween stuff going in with Luke and Alberto.
Alberto, yep. Oh.
And LaDonna. And then there's another article about Q Corner and what we're trying to achieve with it.
Tis a question to be asked.
So, what are there any other competitions?
I think there is.
What we have as the new colour quest for Navy.
Well, I don't have the information.
But we know a Cam that does.
All right, the next contest I want to talk about is for our twisters out there. We are having another color quest. Yay! This one is for navy color, and I've done a quick little bloom dog in navy. Of course, you want to do something more than this, but all the details for entering this contest are found on the website. Let's see, it's at qualatex.com. Click on inspirations. And then after you get to that page, there's on the far right, there's one that says Balloon Contest. You click on that and you can see all the details for entering this contest, and you can get some inspiration by looking at what's been done in the past for their past color quests. The deadline for the Navy color quest is June 1st, so not too much time, but time enough to get something made.
So June 1st.
Yes.
Get your competition entries in.
I'm looking forward to seeing this one particularly because the navy I haven't seen much done with yet.
Yeah.
And it is a really nice colour, especially in the flesh. So, yeah, I'm genuinely looking forward to that. So while we're doing this, we have seen some stuff, but we thought we'd familiarise ourselves. And while we're doing that, we thought there's some really good ones, so we thought we'd share it with you. So if you've got...
Because if you haven't seen them, you can actually go on qualatex.com and you can search it down and you can find the previous entries. Not just the winners, but also the entries.
All of them, yeah. They're all there.
And there's some really cool stuff in there. So we picked out a few.
So again, for your business, you can use it as a link to say that, you know, your entry is on the qualatex.com website.
Yeah,
brilliant to link that into there as well. So let's have a look at that, take that off, and we'll have
this one.
Well, how cool are them?
They were awesome. I have to say, guys, there's some incredible twisters in the Qualatex community.
Yeah, there's some things that just literally blow my mind.
Yeah,
so the techniques.
If you want to be involved, yes, June awesome. The 1st.
Yeah. And even if, you know, you're not going to be involved and you're not going to do it, watch out for those entries coming through as well, though, because you get some really good inspiration that springboards yourself and your own business.
Yeah.
And like I said, Navy, I'm looking forward to that one. But that's two competitions, and then we've got one more.
We've got one more. Yes, James, it is inspiration as well to work with your twisting.
Yeah.
It brings
the game up, I think. Yeah. You know, just goes, oh, let's take ourselves to a new level.
Exactly.
But the competition that we've been following...
Third competition.
So far as well, has been the calendar competition.
So
this is probably the one we've been asked about the most, especially as we've been covering it. How
it hasn't been covered very much up until now, so we thought we would give it that extra airtime, because we think, I mean, getting your photo in an international publication as a calendar.
I mean, the calendars themselves are it's a hot topic. You know, if they came out late this year, I think, and people are like, "Where's my calendar?"
Yeah.
So if you're CBA, I believe you get the calendar.
I think that's
how you get it, to actually receive the calendar. But to be in it, there's only 13 slots. There's 12 months plus the front cover. And as we've already covered the previous months.
Let's
ask.
Who should we ask, Dom?
I think we should ask.
The very wonderful and very beautiful Cam Woody.
The next contest, calendar contest. This is another great marketing tool that you can use in your business, and say that you've been printed on a worldwide publication. Any photos that have been submitted for the Balloon Images cover contest will also be carried over into the calendar contest, so you don't need to submit them twice if you get them in early enough for the Images cover contest. But the difference between these is that this one is horizontal, obviously, instead of vertical. So you might have a wonderful decor shot, but it's horizontal, so it doesn't work for an Images cover. So this gives you another opportunity to showcase your work in a different format. On these particular ones, we look for photos that showcase all aspects of our balloons. We want to have foil balloons, we want to have latex balloons, we want to have balloon sculptures, we've got some party scenes, we've got pool floats, we've got bubbles, and if you have a twisted piece that you'd like featured in here, we even do those. We want to have all aspects of our balloons. And you can increase your chances by creating something that's particularly seasonal, because we do look for something that works well with the month that we're featuring. And this one is by Azusa and Akani, and they worked our foils in, and they've got the theme of the candy and holiday time. It's a lot of fun, and it was perfect for December for us. I can show you a few other past winners that we've had. This one is a lot of fun. This one I'm sure you've seen all over the world. This one has just exploded as far as popularity of this particular design. And one of the fun sculptures from a past competition. So when you enter these, we're looking for basically the same sort of criteria as you have for the Balloon Images cover contest. So I hope that you'll take time and, the deadline for this contest is August 1st. So you have a little bit more time for the calendar contest, but if you want to enter both the Images cover contest and the calendar, it's May 18th for that deadline. So I hope you'll take time and get your work together, send us your best stuff, and I wish you all luck and hope to see you on one of the covers or in the Color Quest contest. Thanks. Take it away, Keith and Dom.
Great job, Cam. That was awesome. Thank you very much for that, Cam. We really appreciate it.
We're sorry that you were off screen a little bit when you first started. I think
don't know what happened there.
I think the extra, you know, the down under moved everything out the way, but we got you back quick enough.
Oh, you've got the wrong one. We've got the thingy one on there. You've got the early bird deadline, apparently, for the 30th of April, which is Oz Jam.
That's not the right date.
Yeah, you heard it on Cam. But also what will happen as well is when this video is posted again after the live broadcast, we'll put all of the details with the competition rules and the links and everything that you need.
There's quite a bit of information in the description there about size of images, resolution, all that. That's all in there for each of the competition, three ones. Make sure you read each one correctly for the competition that you want to enter. You're more than welcome to enter more than one, and you're also more than welcome to send multiple images,
multiple entries,
and also group ones are welcome as well. So if you're working on a project with somebody else, that's absolutely fine. You'll be credited accordingly. So that's on there. Also, in the additional video that we'll post for Andre's video, we'll post the list of products that you need as well in the description.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. So for our international people, we appreciate that there's some guys or some people that follow us that English is not the first language, and we've had the feedback already that if we put it in the description underneath, it's easier for them to translate. So we'll do that.
The ingredients there, and if there's any bits we can put in there to help, we shall certainly do that. But that'll be done afterwards once it's gone live.
We truly appreciate all the comments that we get from you guys about the show. So if you do have anything, any suggestions that we can improve, things that we can do better, things that you would like to see more of, less of, whatever.
I'll challenge him.
then please feel free. Send us the comments. We'll take it all on board. You can send it. You can do a comment on the video, or you can send a message to Mr. Q on Facebook.
Just mark it for our attention. We'll find it.
Fantastic. Thank you, guys. Right, we have one last thing.
Wait.
I know, Dom. We're not doing the weight joke anymore.
I was just saying what it was.
We've got one last thing. Now, you've been in control of this one. You've written down a list of everything that we need and what have you. So,
we need...
First of all, what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to do sand weights.
Yeah, again, one of those little things that we do that many people do on a daily basis, and either it's something you already do, and this might be a different method that you might find works for you, or we often find when we show people to go, oh.
There's one little bit that's... We used to do it a different way, and then there was one little bit that changed everything for us, and we kind of went,
A lot easier, or... For other people, it's just completely different, and it's just another tool in your toolbox that's a way to tackle your daily business. I did write a list, and the first thing on my list was to bring the list. So I'll try and remember the bits and pieces from memory. Okay, so first of all, we need a bottle. That's what we need.
We need a bottle. Yes. I have a bottle. One bottle.
First of all, we need a plastic bottle, not a glass bottle.
This is my favourite bottle.
I can appreciate that, but we need a plastic bottle.
Plastic bottle, Dom.
Yeah.
We have
a plastic bottle, Dom.
We need a small plastic bottle, ideally.
Small plastic bottle.
Not a full plastic bottle.
Because
we need to empty
Look at this. We've got a small plastic bottle. This is one I got off a flight somewhere. It's one of them plastic wine bottles.
So I did say we needed a small plastic bottle earlier on. And I did also say we needed to empty that small plastic bottle. So that's why I assume you got the alcoholic larger bottle followed
you
by
didn't
the small...
Say, you didn't
I
say,
did.
You I, didn't say we needed water.
I did specifically say a small plastic water bottle or pop
Here we
bottle.
Go, look at that. We got a bottle of water.
Perfect. I did say that. I also said it needs to be empty.
Empty.
Empty, yes.
I can
please.
Do this. Not a problem. One second.
So while... My colleague empties his water bottle, which I recommend using a sink or planning ahead and perhaps having it empty.
And if he drowned,
ready.
I could have drowned there. There was no lifeguard on.
Or, ideally in advance, you could prepare and we'll just use this one.
So I didn't even need to do this. You just did that.
I was just
looked after.
Trying to make the point that we needed a small plastic bottle, and I wanted to get over that fact.
Jesus,
so, one plastic bottle, which is dry. It is important that it is dry, so please empty that bottle out. Additionally, we need a...
That went on my nose.
11-inch balloon.
11-inch balloon.
Don't try that at home.
And do we need two?
We do need two, but I buried it. Second 11-inch balloon, a Qualatex balloon, of course. And our trusty balloon straw, which if you can see it, yes you can see it. It's like it's a
balloon straw. Here we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to first of all, that's really cold, just so you know. Don't try that at home. Do it at somebody else's home.
Yes.
So we've got a pink balloon and a rose balloon.
My wheel had a restrictive moment on the carpet. I think it's the water.
Really?
Yes. So double stuffing it. So we have two balloons for added security of our weight.
There we go. We've got two balloons. We could do with some sand.
We could. So we're going to use our imported sand from Sao Paulo. This is a quality sand that we've brought in.
All the way from the Sao Paulo event.
2016. It's a very good year's worth of sand. I mean, you can use sand from other beaches, but we do recommend Sao Paulo beach sand.
We actually use kiln-dried sand. We don't use play sand because it tends to be too expensive, but we do kiln-dried sand, or also known as paver's sand. It's the stuff that they brush in between when they're doing paving.
Block paving
or whatever.
Generally inexpensive, and most of the time it is pretty dry.
Which is the important bit, because it needs to be dry for the movement of the sand.
And if it isn't dry, we empty it out. We have a container, a bucket that it goes into, so it's decanted into that. So it's a day at worst for it to dry out. But it must be dry.
We've got a funnel.
Funnily enough, I don't. Shall I go get a funnel?
There should have been a funnel there.
One moment. Was it over here?
I thought I put a funnel. I must have took it through there. We'll do it. Let's do it. We would normally use a funnel on this, but what we'll do is we'll do not a Balloon Images magazine. Balloon Images magazine funnel.
So there's a very
Qualatex funnel.
There's very inexpensive funnels that you can buy, or you can do it the unprepared way.
Up. Thank you. We don't normally recommend this. We would normally use a funnel. But, funnily enough...
I've done that joke already. Stop filling.
I'm filling the bottle. Hey!
I left that for you. You're welcome. Boom, boom.
Right, okay, that's enough.
Another great use. Thank you, Tanya.
So now we have our bottle of sand, which we can use a slightly larger one. We normally do, but for the show, we're just using the small one.
You got the hand pump.
And we need... hand pump.
You can also mark as well on the side of the bottle different marks for different amounts of sand, for the volume, for the weights that you're creating.
But this is the key. What we used to do was we used to put this over the top, flip it over, and then squeeze the bottle, which takes a lot of effort.
Yep.
And then we had an inspiration one day to inflate the balloons. If we inflate the balloons and then put that over, what happens is when we flip it up, the air goes up, which forces the sand to go down. So that just goes down like that, and it just does it itself. So there's no effort involved.
No frantic squeezing.
And then they come off. Let the air out. Down to the size so that it's padded. And then from there, I'll just give it a tap, because I want the last of that air out so that we can shape the weight. And then I'm just taking the inside balloon, around it goes, and pull tight.
One of the added benefits of a sand weight versus water weight is a water weight will always be round. You can't change the shape of the balloon. It will always be a big round weight, which means sometimes you're restricted on the size of the weight you can make, because it's going to have that curve of the balloon on the underside of your design.
But with a sand weight, we can make it flat as long as you knock the air out of the balloon.
So it means you can get a bigger weight in the space that you would have normally, but also sand's heavier than water for its volume. So
yes,
it means, especially when you're making a design that's got maybe a couple of layers of 5-inch and you want to have a really, you know, solid weight to it, so it has that feel of a presence to it, the design. So when a customer picks it up, it feels like it's worth a bit more. So the sand for us adds to that, as opposed to the water that's kind of sloshing around. I know sometimes we need to use a water weight, but our preferred method is the sand.
Also, if you get any kind of piercing through the outer skins of a water weight, all of the water disappears.
Absolutely.
Doesn't matter where it is. Where this, we could put a pin into there and you wouldn't lose anything at all.
No. You've got that double skin, which is great, but also the sand struggles to get through a pinhole in it as well. So even if it is dragged and hit and kicked on the floor, it's going to survive. It's going to outlast the decor, absolutely.
So that's our sand weight top tip.
Absolutely. Ideal.
And also, that is the end of Q Corner Showtime Live for April.
Oh no, that's sad.
I know. We're already in May. We're just around the corner to May.
Wow. But that does mean we're closer to August, which means we're closer to Australia.
That's right. Okay. So thank you very much for watching, guys.
Yes.
We look forward to reading all your comments.
Yep. And sending in those pictures and tagging on
hashtag.
Thank you very much.
Q Corner or hashtag Qualatex Corner.
Yes, absolutely. So see you next time.
Thanks for watching. Bye bye now.